Hi all, welcome to the CA classroom. What are we going to see today? We are going to see what are the different types of audit firms operating in India and what are the various services they provide. Why should I know all of this? No. Before you join Articleship, having an understanding about this helps you decide better what firm you want to join and into which specialization you want to get into. Now, coming to the firms, we have four types of firms in India. This classification is not done by ICA or something. It's just what I am doing to help you understand it easily. First is the Big Four. You have this top four MNC firms operating in India. They have all the fields. They have operated into audit, tax and consultancy. Now what am I writing in consultancy? Anything which a firm is offering other than audit and tax services are bucketed under consultancy services. Big Four provide audit. Now under audit, most important, half their revenue or significant amount of their revenue comes from statutory audit. This is something available across all the firms, but what differs is the size of the audit. In a Big Four or a next to Big Four type of firm, you will get listed audits or big companies, you will see huge numbers. You will do the same audit, same process in a small firm or medium firm, but the chance of getting exposed to a listed company audit is less. Next is internal audit. Now, some firms call it internal audit, some firms call it risk assurance, risk advisory, but primarily the work they do is internal audit with some other support services. Coming to tax. Tax can be classified into direct tax, indirect tax and transfer pricing. Transfer pricing is a subset of direct tax, but Big Fours have a separate department for it, so I'm breaking it as a separate department. Now, in direct tax, what is the kind of work you do? You will be doing income tax, for example, tax audits, any requirement under the income tax, direct tax related work, you will be doing it over here, assessment, appeals, etc. Similarly, in indirect tax, you will be doing GST related work, customs related work, GST returns, GST audit, any appeals, assessment, cases, etc. Similarly, in transfer pricing, you will be computing the arm's length price, preparing a report and submitting a report. Majorly in transfer pricing, you will be seeing multinational companies, big corporates, because transfer pricing is generally not applicable to small companies because of their nature of transactions. Let's not get much into that. Coming to consultancy, now, Big Four, the work it does, other than audit and tax, I am bucketing under consultancy. Example, transaction advisory services. They have a department which deals in mergers and acquisitions, due diligence, valuations and all of that. Forensic audit, instead of putting it under audit, I am putting it over here. Forensic audit is a new upcoming field. Next you have CFO advisory in some Big Fours. Then you have something called accounting advisory services, or it's also called as FAS. What they do here is, Ind AS related advisory is done here, and there are many other departments where people work in. No. Can I join Articleship into these consultancies? Even if you are interested, majority of the firms do not take articles here because it requires a lot of thinking. It's a super specialization, so they don't prefer articles. But if there are some firms which are taking them for articles, you can try if you are interested in any of these fields. Coming back to audit. Major work involves statutory audit, internal audit. What do you do in stat audit? You will get overall understanding of a company, end-to-end audit. I suggest every CA should know how to do a stat audit. Under internal audit, what do you learn? You learn the operations of a company, how a company works, what are its controls. For example, a company has a hiring process. In internal audit, you will check if the company is following this hiring process. For sales, they'll have another process. You will check if the process is good. So, if a company is having some controls, you will check if these controls are operating effectively. That is the main work, but there is a lot of subset and work in internal audit. But this is about a general overview on internal audit. What happens is, students don't know all these things exist. They get whatever is offered to them. Sometimes, they offer them a post in direct tax. You will go blindly into any Big Four into direct tax. And later, I've seen people regret it. So what is important here is, you need to understand what are the different service offerings and what you choose. In my view, for articleship, statutory audit is the best, because from statutory audit, you can jump anywhere in the future, but from other lines, it's difficult to come back to audit. This is like the base where you get to learn everything. If you're a student who's saying, sir, I don't know what I want to do in the future, I don't know what is all this, I have no idea, best for you is a statutory audit, because you will learn end to end. Later, you can choose any of the specializations you want. But if you are somebody who is already aware, I love tax, I love GST, I want to spend my next 20 years in GST, then you can very well go to a firm which is offering specialization of articleship in indirect tax. Similarly for other departments, if you love it, if you already want to be here for the future, then you can go into articleship in these things. Coming to firms next to Big Four. No. What are these firms? These are firms which are there for 50 plus years. Elite firms, has very good brand name in the market. Indian firms, very good top firms. There are about 15-20 top firms in India. Any of these firms you can join. Some of these firms have specialization and some of these firms don't have a specialization, but still there is very good learning. You can join any of these firms. All these elite firms after Big Four, top firms with 50 plus partners, 20 plus partners, 10 plus partners in existence for more than 100 years, have very good audits, very good brand name in the market. These are the firms next to Big Four. So those who don't get into Big Fours can always go for this next to Big Four firms, and you learn a lot over here also. Next, coming to this medium-sized firms. Firms with 3 to 5 partners or 7 partners, small firms, last 10 years, growing firms, startups, all these come over here. Now, what do you learn here? Majorly, you will be learning statutory audit, maybe a little bit of internal audit, and a little bit of taxation. Mostly in these firms, they won't have departmentalization. So based on engagement, you will be put into stat audit, internal audit, or any tax engagement. But the size of the engagement will be small. Very rare to find a listed company audit over here. You will find a lot of listed audits in Big Four or next to Big Four firms. So you will do the same work, but the size of your work, the size of the company will be much smaller. Coming to small firms. What are small firms? 2 partners, 1 sole proprietor. Very, very small firms. Here, what do you learn? Mainly, there will be tax-related work, where you will do individual filings. You will be good in direct tax and indirect tax, GST filings, individual filings, and a little bit of stat audit for small companies, private limited companies, public limited companies, small companies. Now, what is important is, now that you know the different services provided and different types of firms, you can choose what suits you the best and choose it. Let's say a student does not want to undergo so much pressure, there will be a lot of work in a Big Four, then he can choose a firm which is next to Big Four or medium-sized firm, where he'll have little more time than a student who's doing articleship in Big Four. However, if you see results, Big Four always has good results. That is because the exposure in Big Four is very good, that most of your final subjects, to an extent, they get exposed in their articleship work, and they also get 5 months of study leave. But other firms generally give 3 to 4 months of study leave. All of that matters, but end of the day, once you're aware of this, now you can choose which field you want and then apply for it. Instead of blindly going and joining in transfer pricing or IDT without having an idea about what I'm going to do for the next 3 years. Because what you learn in these 3 years is what makes you a good CA once you qualify.